Hey, another video. You know, I wish I could sing. I really do wish I could sing. So this video is about stretching your hair with no heat. That way, I mean, there's a couple of different ways to do it, but I'm doing one. Okay. So my hair is shampooed and damp. I air dry it for a night. I just put it all up in a kind of a bun or whatever. So my hair is damp. So you do need to let most of the water come out of your hair, either by drying it with a towel or, if you have time, letting it air dry. So I'm going to pin up one section, and I'm using my Remington Steel. It's not steel, but anybody old enough to remember that show? I'm using my dryer, my blow dryer, on the cool setting, but on the high blow. And I'm using the concentrator. If you have a comb attachment, that's fine. But anyway, what I just flashed by, because I'm talking, looking somewhere else while I'm doing this video, was the Kera Care Creme Press. So even though I am stretching my hair with the cool blow dryer, and my cool is actually cool, like it's not warm, it's cool, I still am paranoid about heat damage because my curls be popping, okay, with this third or fourth batch of hair that I have, and I'm not trying to mess that up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my Felicia Leatherwood detangling brush, and you can either hold the hair in the brush, hold it taut, which is stretched, tight, okay, taut is fancy for tight, and just kind of run that cool blow dryer. Don't concentrate in any one area, but just kind of, you know, blowing through that hair to get it dry. Or you just hold it with your hand if you, you know, don't want to hold the hair on the brush. Then take your brush or your wide tooth comb and brush through the hair as you're blow drying it. And that's going to allow you to stretch the hair, but not subject yourself to any heat damage. This is also a quicker way to do stretching of the hair than the banding, right? Because let me tell you something. I tried that banding on Simone. I tried it on myself, and somehow I'm not able to wrap it right with the string. Like, I just, it was just too much for me. I see the Africans and others do it, and they be just wrapping, and it goes fast for them, and it does not go fast for me. So this is what goes fast for me. So again, just holding that hair taut, drying through it with that cool dryer on the cool setting, because you really don't need the heat to stretch it. You really need the tension to hold it and allow it to dry in that held state. So then I'm going to just twist this section up and then move on to the next section. Yes. Now, my Kera Care Creme Press is a heat protectant. It's a pressing cream that I used to use back in the day when I would press my hair. I've used it for 100 years, maybe 120, somewhere around in there. And I really, really like it, obviously, because I've been using it so long. So yeah, that's all that I'm doing right here. Where's the next segment? Oh, it's coming. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is coming. All right, hold on. And hey, okay, so I got the whole head done, and what I'm doing now is just going through it one more again, still on the cool setting, with my brush, so I can get it completely stretched out. Okay. And this is as good as I need it stretched. Now, my plan is to do a rod set, but I don't want the rod set all shrunk up so I'm looking like Sophia from the Golden Girls, or I'm looking like Shirley Temple. Neither one of those is the look I was going for. So I wanted to stretch my hair first and then put a little set lotion on it and then rod set it. Now, as I do this voiceover, okay, I took the rods out and then I pin curled them, and I'm hoping it's going to come out right. I'm not feeling confident about it. So while I did record a video, I'm not sure if y'all going to see it. But then you might see it to see what not to do. We're going to see. So I don't know why I'm putting these clips on here. I'm putting the clips on here to keep it kind of stretched out until I get my scarf, and then I take the clips back out because I'll be doing the most. And I'm going to tie my scarf on, and that's going to help it stay stretched and smooth it a little bit more, especially around those edges where my gray hairs are like, I don't know, whatever. So I'm going to put my scarf on, and then, come on, child, get the scarf together. fold, take your square scarf, fold it over so you get a triangle, tie that down on your head, make sure it's a satiny scarf. And then I'm going to tie it around to the front, get my ears out because I can't stand for my ears to be tied down. Make it fairly tight, you know, fairly tight so like it can lay the hair down, but I didn't put anything else on it. I didn't put anything else on it. Then what I do is I'm going to twist it around in the back, the hair, okay, that's under the scarf. And then I'm going to twist that around in a bun, okay, and then put a little rubber band on it, hair band on it. And that's going to keep that all stretched out as well until it just kind of like gets to be okay with being stretched. And I'm ready to, belch because I have bacon, until I'm ready to roller set. Okay, hopefully you enjoyed or whatever. Bye. I'm cross-eyed.